Thank you for coming out here, everybody. It still amazes me seeing the numbers that we have, seeing all of the support, seeing after over 40 days, people being this riled up, this active. Let us hear a chant. Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
From my family in Gaza that I've been asked by them to share with you. Specifically for graduation season coming, you know, for many of our students here, even part of the camp, part of Occupy, are graduating. You know, our family and friends in Gaza know about what's been going on. They see what's happening at the camp. They've been following every step of the way. They have an ear to the ground. They know about the fences. They know about the injunction. They know about everything that the university administration has been doing to us. Yet even there from the ground, they're active. They're listening. They're supporting us. Despite our university not hearing us, the people in Gaza hear us. Shame on the university.
Shame!
I'm going to read this message from Asad al-Masri. He's a family member of mine from my mother's side of the family. I'll read it in Arabic first and then read the English translation. Again, please bear with me.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ikhwani wa akhawati marawatina fi haram jami'at Toronto, nusrata lil haqq wal adala. Amtarakum Allah min barakatihi wa rahmatihi wa tawfiqih. آمين. قال تعالى في كتابه العزيز في سورة المجادلة آية رقم 11 من بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات والله ما تعملون خبير. يبالغ الفرح والسرور نزف لكم أسماء آيات التهاني والتبريكات بمناسبة موسم التخرج ونتوجكم بباقات الفرح والنجاح والتميز والمرصعة بجواهر العلم اللائي وأولي الإنجازات راجين الله عز وجل أن يجعلكم فخرا لوالديكم وأوطانكم وينفع بعلمكم ويسخر طاقاتكم اليافعة لنشر الفرح والخير والأمل بمستقبل زاهر. آمين. فالحمد لله بنعمته تتم الصالحات وبفضله تتحقق الأمنيات سبحانه ييسر الباديات وأكمل النهايات وبلغ الغايات. أحبابنا المرابطين الشرفاء، لا يخفى عليكم بأن الاحتلال الغاشم نسف كل المنظومات الحيوية في غزة، فلا نجد منه جامعة ولا روضة أطفال ولا مستشفى ولا عيادة ولا مسجد ولا كنيسة. هدفهم واضح وصرحوا به علانية، جعل الحياة في غزة مستحيلة، فمن لم يمت من القصف البربري الأعمى سيموت من الأمراض والجوع، مما يسهل عليهم تهجير الأهالي قصرا. نسأل الله أن لا يحقق لهم غايتهم ولا يرفع لهم رايتهم. آمين. مضت السنة الدراسية في غزة من دون أن نفرح بتخرج الأكاديمي لفلذات أكبادنا وأقربنا وأحبابنا، ولكننا ماضين نزف شهدائنا الطاهرين كل يوم منذ يقارب من 9 أشهر. نعم، نجحت آليات الحرب الهمجية التي يقودها الدماء والأطراف والأشلاء الممولة من ضرائبكم ورسومكم الدراسية بهدم كل الصروح العلمية في القطاع، ولكن نعلم ما نجي من أطفالنا، ولكن تعلم ما نجا من أطفالنا فصولا من الصبر والإيمان والثبات لا تعلمها سنوات طويلة من جنبات أرقى المعاهد والجامعات. لقد وصلتنا أخبار مبادرة حفل التخرج الفخري الذي أقمتموه على شرف الطلاب الغزيين الذين ارتقوا شهداء عند ربهم وتخرجوا من الدنيا الفانية إلى جنات النعيم بإذن الله. والآخرين الذين نجوا من الموت ولكنهم حرموا وأهاليهم من فرحة التخرج لنسف جامعاتهم ومدارسهم وحضاناتهم. فطوبى لكم أيها المناضلين المباركين، فقد علمتمونا وأطفالنا
فن جبر الخواطر بحراككم، جبر الله خواطركم وأصلح بالكم. أعزائنا البواسل الأحرار، متى استعبدتم الناس وقد ولدتم وقد ولدتهم أمهاتهم أحرارا؟ لم تكن هذه العبارة التي قالها عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه ثاني الخلفاء الراشدين في موقف حدث في فترة خلافته، سواء أول ما خط في مواثيق الحقوق الإنسان الحديثة من بنود التكفل حق الإنسان في الحرية والمساواة. فمنذ فجر التاريخ وجميع الديانات السماوية لا ترى فرقا لعربي على أعجمي إلا بالتقوى. فبنو آدم سواسية في كرامتهم وحريتهم كأسنان المشط، وإن اختلفت الأعراق وتعددت المذاهب. ونحن نرى تجليات هذه العقيدة اليوم بين ثنايا تكاتفكم وتعاضدكم، متوحدين رافضين للتطهير العرقي والمذابح المتلفزة والمحرقة التي يتعرض لها شعبنا وألوان العذاب والموت التي نشهدها في كل لحظة. فبعد تدمير الصهاينة لمعبر رفح واحتلالهم لمحور فيلادلفيا، قطعوا شريان الحياة الوحيد الذي يغذي شمال القطاع بالفتاة من الطعام والدواء. نحن الآن في شمال غزة نعاني من مجاعة حقيقة. قد تفتك بنا، ومهزلة الجسر البحري الأمريكي ما هي إلا مسرحية عمليات عسكرية وغزو غير مباشر لتتراطم بها أمواج غزة العاتية فتفككها. ومع ذلك كله نحن نرفل في نعم الله وفضله. ادعوا لنا بالثبات والنصر، بارك الله فيكم. لقد من الله عليكم بأن أيدكم بنصرة السكان الأصليين والكادر الأكاديمي ونقابة العمال في مقاطعة أونتاريو وغيرهم من الشرفاء. بل وحول الله مكر رئاسة الجامعة بكم إلى تضامن لا مثيل له على الصعيد العالمي. فمن كرم وحكمة الله أن يجعل في كل محنة منها. اعلموا رعاكم الله بأنكم انتصرتم منذ أن كسرتم حاجز الخوف وتسررتم بعباءة الليل لتنصبوا خيامكم، فأيقظتم بأول وتد دق الأرض قلوب مجتمعكم، وأحييتم بنضالكم شمعة آمالنا التي كادت أن تنطفأ، وسطرتم بمواقفكم أبهى مظاهر العزة والإباء، ووضعتم بصمتكم في ذاكرة الأيام، فغذلتم مواقفهم فخذلتم مواقفكم بألوان التضامن التي سخرتموها لدعم القضايا الإنسانية. يا وجدان عبق التاريخ ومناضلين الحاضر وحملة شعلة المستقبل الواعي، إن تخرجكم يحاكي المخاض من حقبة التلقي إلى غمار الحياة العملية والعطاء. أنصحكم بعد التخرج أن تستمروا في تطور أنفسكم في مجالاتكم، وأن تبدعوا فيما حباكم الله به من مواهب، وأن توقدوا في قلوبكم قبص الشغف والمعرفة والثقافة. كل تجربة تمرون بها تمثل محطة في رحلة العمر من المثابرة من المثابرة والصراعات النفسية والإبدارية للوصول إلى أهدافكم وطموحاتكم عبر صقل شخصياتكم. انظروا إلى التخرج كمفتاحا للسعي نحو آفاق أخرى وعوالم غامضة مثيرة. لا تستسلموا للاكتئاب والحزن، ولا تقعوا فريسة سهلة للفراغ. املؤوا أوقاتكم بما ينفعكم أولا، ثم انفعوا مجتمعاتكم بما تعلمتم. المعادلة سهلة وبسيطة: الله ثم النفس ثم الآخر. وفي الختام اسمحوا لنا أن نلبسكم وسام الفخر والشرف من غزة العزة عبر الأثير. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أخوكم عاصم زهير علي المصري وعائلته. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. May peace, mercy and blessing of Allah be unto you. Our dearest brothers and sisters camping at the People's Circle for Palestine in defense of truth and justice, I ask Allah to shower you with abundance and success. Ameen. Allah says in His miraculous and honorable book, the Quran, after, in the name of Allah, the most gracious and the most merciful, Allah will exalt in degrees those of you who believe, and those of you, and those who have been granted knowledge, and Allah is well acquainted with what you do. With utmost pleasure and delight, we extend our heartfelt congratulations on the occasion of your graduation season. We hereby crown you with the fragrant florals of excellence, studded with jewels of knowledge and pearls of achievement, praying that God Almighty will make you a treasure for your parents and your homelands, and harness your youthful energies to spread joy and goodness, and hope for a bright future. Ameen. Praise be to Allah, by whose grace and good deeds are accomplished, and by His favor wishes are fulfilled. Our beloved honorable campers, the double standards and hypocrisy of the world's narrative when it comes to the live stream genocide and ethnic cleansing of the indigenous Palestinians by the inhumane Zionist occupation cannot be denied. They annihilated all vital systems supporting collective life and spared no critical infrastructure, be it university or hospital, or kindergarten and clinic, mosque nor church, driven by a clear demonic agenda to make life in Gaza impossible. Whoever does not die from the barbaric carpet bombing will perish from other manufactured atrocities, such as disease, hunger, and thirst, which facilitates forcibly displacing the inhabitants. The 2023-2024 academic year was folded into the vivid traumatic memory of the Ghazans' consciousness, deprived from joyous graduation celebrations of our family members and loved ones. However, we continue to conduct daily funeral processions during which our innocent martyrs ascend heavenward, leaving us behind, drowned in scenes of devastation. Academic institutions were obliterated by the military-industrial complex and warmongers, whose fuel is bloodshed, limb amputations, decapitations, and mass incinerations, funded by your tax dollars and tuition fees. Shame! Yet our surviving children obtain doctorate degrees in the arts and sciences of patience, faith, and perseverance, which can never be achieved in the halls of the most prestigious universities, colleges, and institutes. We were profoundly touched to hear about the sentimental protest graduation and vigil, which you held to honor students who were killed by the ongoing Zionist Holocaust on Gaza. Our blessed freedom activists, you have taught us along with our children the art of alleviating exhausted souls and mending tender broken hearts through your beautifully orchestrated tributes. May Allah engulf you with His infinite abundance and elevate your status in this world and the hereafter. Ameen. Dear unsung brave heroes and social reformists, since when have people been taken for slaves, though their mothers bore them free? This famous phrase, which was uttered by Umar ibn al-Khattab, the second of the rightly guided caliphs, may Allah be pleased with him, was nothing but the first of the clauses written in the modern human rights charters, guaranteeing the human rights to freedom and equality. Since the dawn of history, divine religions have not endorsed the superiority for one human over another, except through piety, for the children of Adam are equal in their dignity and freedom, like the teeth of a comb, even if their races and jurisprudence differ. Today we witness the living manifestations of this notion, which eradicates discrimination and elitism in your solidarity. After the Zionists destroyed the Rafah crossing and occupied the Philadelphia Axis, they slit the only artery which supplied the northern Gaza Strip with scraps of food and scarce medicine. As a result, a devastating famine struck us, and death lurks at every corner. We are not fooled by the American gloating, pure facade, as it did not bring us the promised aid. Rather, an indirect invasion and military operations, while Gaza's stormy waves disintegrated by Allah's will. Despite the arrays of suffering we are subjected to, and our vulnerability, we rejoice in Allah's grace and mercy. Please pray for our steadfastness and victory. May Allah grant you peace. Ameen. Kindly take a moment to acknowledge and contemplate Allah's abundance unto you, as He has bestowed you with the support of the Indigenous people of Toronto, esteemed faculty members, the Ontario Federal Federation of Labor, and other honorable people throughout the land. It is fascinating how Allah turned the deception and plotting of your university's administration into unparalleled solidarity campaigns in your favor on the national, if not global level. It is from the generosity and wisdom of Allah that He transformed every adversity and hardship into blessings and opportunities. No, may Allah preserve you upon goodness, that you have been victorious ever since you broke the barrier of fear and took cover under the cloak of darkness to erect your encampment. You awakened the hearts of your community with the first stake that you struck into the ground, and with your solidarity, you reignited the lanterns of hope that had almost been extinguished. With your stances, you engraved historic manifestations of dignity, and with advocacy that you have harnessed to support humanitarian causes, you immortalized your activism. O revivers of history, the fighters of the present and the torchbearers of a conscious future, your graduation simulates the throes of birth from the era of acquisition to the midst of a practical life and bestowal. I advise you after graduating to continue developing and elevating your skills in the fields that you choose, to harness the talents that Allah has blessed you with, and to kindle in your hearts a spark of passion for the sweet nectar of knowledge. Remember that every experience you embark on represents a station in life's voyage and perseverance through which you are carried aloft to reach your goals and ambitions. Look at graduation as a key to striving towards new horizons and discovering exciting, mysterious worlds. Do not succumb to depression and sadness, and do not be an easy prey to futility. Fill your time with what benefits you first, then assist your communities with what you have acquired, aiming to improve the quality of life around you. In other words, be a source of good. The anatomy of the human experience equation is easy and simple. Allah comes first, oneself second, and then others. In conclusion, and from Gaza, through the virtual algorithms, allow us to decorate your necks and garlands of glory and chests with badges of honor. May peace, mercy, and blessing of Allah be unto you all. Your brother Asim Zuhair, Ali al-Masri, and his family. Thank you.
Gaza, Gaza, you will run!
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala nabiyin al-mujahid al-sharif. Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsan ila yawmiddin. Dear respected brothers and sisters, I greet you with the words of peace. Many days have now passed, many months have concluded, and yet the genocide of the Palestinian people continues. The same words continue to be repeated to the same institutions, yet they seem to be deafened by their own greed, their capitalist aspirations, their delusional bureaucratic policies and principles. And so the same words that have been said for 7 months have not sparked any real change. The same words that have been repeated for 76 years fall on ears not willing to listen. And today is also another day in which the same words are said. Words that are to convey justice and truth. Words calling this institution to take its morality seriously. But the university continues turning its face away from the reality it should face. The ongoing massacre has passed the 8-month mark. Over 35,000 people have been massacred, almost half of them children. And Israel continues to bomb Gaza. In fact, they've also invaded Rafah and continue to do so, which is one of the most densely populated regions, if not one of the most densely populated regions on this planet, especially with the displacement of hundreds of thousands from northern Gaza. And so with families wiped out, places of knowledge and prayers destroyed, and histories erased, our institutions remain silent. They don't listen to their students even. This institution, University of Toronto, that claims to uphold itself to the ideals of justice, this institution that holds multiple classes on moral philosophy, has still decided that there's some uncertainty in the immorality that has been occurring for the past 76 years. They stand in complicity with genocide, but they state that they stand for peace. When they are told, do not spread corruption, they reply, we're only trying to follow policies and principles and bureaucratic systems that will facilitate peace. But instead, what's really the case is that they're the ones facilitating the lack of peace and the lack of justice and the lack of fairness in this world. These institutions, whether Western governing ones like the Canadian government or the academic ones like this university, speak about the rule-based order, but the rules seem to be all for naught when it comes to real bodies falling on the ground. These institutions seek a peace without confronting their sensibilities that are so skewed, they're willing to let thousands of people die, children die, but won't budge as a change would make their delusion questionable. They are the ones upholding corruption through their corrupt systems, prioritizing capital over morality. But when asked, they say they seek peace in the land. To that I say, أَلَا لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْكَاذِبِينَ. May the curse of God be upon these liars. To move on and to end, I want to say a few words on the atrocity that has been unfolding before us. It's a deeply demoralizing and a hard place to see children dead. The pictures that come out of Gaza, the pictures that come out of Sudan, they're very unsettling, but they're pictures that we must witness to talk about the reality that many institutions in this world are trying to hide before us. Many realities that these institutions, because of their uncomfortability and their participation, don't want us to speak about. But we will stay here and we'll continue to speak about them until this university will disclose, divest, and we will not stop and we will not rest until then.